Hey AIS students, this is your work for the week of September 14th all the way to September 18th. Your work for this week is from Pearson, so in order to get to Pearson's, you've got to log into Clever and you need to find the Pearson's Easy Bridge icon. So it is a white icon with a orange circle that has a bridge on it. When you click on it, you may have to log in again, sorry. So after you click on the icon and you log in, you need to look under assignments to find the virtual lab, living or not. That will be your assignment. So I've already assigned it to you, so it should be there. If you're having trouble finding it, check under the incomplete tab. Sometimes your homework gets stuck under that tab. Okay, so this will be the home page when you click on the virtual lab. And I know that it is a little confusing and overwhelming, but you don't have to read all the labels. Just click on the blue get started button and all of that nonsense will go away. Okay, so to completely finish the assignment, you need to complete all of the tabs. What do I mean? Well, please look here. You need to finish scenario, investigate, analyze, conclude, and imagine. Just be careful if you're not completely done and you click next, it might take you to the next tab, even though you haven't finished all of the activities. And again, remember for Pearson's, if you can't move on, it's probably because you didn't click something. If you see this picture of the microscope and the slides and the boxes, it's all interactive. If it's outlined blue, it usually means it wants you to click on it, and you can even click on the posters in the background of this picture. Everything will expand and become bigger so you can actually read it. So on the Analyze tab, you're going to be doing most of your work. You have these slides, which are these rectangular pieces of glass that you're going to pull underneath your microscope. And as soon as you put the slide on the microscope, this screen is going to pop up. And you're looking at this circle, you're looking at your field of view, and you're like, well, there's nothing under here. Not true. What this lab wants you to pretend is that you're actually using a microscope. And if you remember from museum microscope in class or from a past science class, you know that when you look underneath it, you don't automatically see something. It's not like your phone where you can just flip open the photo app, tap your finger, and the camera will automatically zoom in. So it wants you to act like you're really using a microscope. And when you do look at things underneath the microscope, you often need to use the coarse adjustment, which is here, that I've been calling it the big guy in class. So you're going to turn that first with your mouse. And then when you're done, you're going to use the fine adjustment, and that's going to make the picture clearer. So just because you don't see anything, don't automatically think there's nothing there. Try to use these two knobs. The big guy is the coarse adjustment, and the little guy is the fine adjustment. And when you move those a few times, you're going to get a much clearer picture, like here. And then after you see more clearly, you're going to decide if that slide should go into the non-living animal or plant box. So you hit back to lab bench and then you get to pull that slide into the box. So I see this picture. I'm looking at this cell. I see that it doesn't really, I gave it away. So I'm looking under here. I think it's a cell because I see these little dots, these little purple dots, and usually those are nucleus or nuclei. And also when I'm looking at this cell, and remember cells were named after the jail first, right? So if you see all these little tiny boxes, it's usually a living thing because cells look like lots of tiny little boxes underneath the microscope. Now, I noticed that the outline of the boxes is very irregular shaped, or it's like random, like a potato. Potatoes are all different shapes and sizes, and they don't have a specific size or shape. So if it's an irregularly shaped cell, it's usually an animal cell. So when I would be done, I would hit back to the lab bench and I would pull this slide off the microscope and into the animal slide. And again, you need to do that for all 9 slides. And when you're done with all 9 slides and separating them into boxes, then you can hit next and finish up the conclude tab. And then when you're done with that, you can finish up the imagine tab. And then you are done for work with me for this week. Please don't forget that I will be on Teams during our regular class time to answer any questions. If you're doing your work at night, no problem, and you have a question for me, please just shoot me a message on Schoology or an email, and I will try to get back to you the next day. All right, guys, if I don't hear from you, have a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you on Monday.